How's it going, everyone? My name is Kel, and welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Dark Souls 3. So, I just equipped this armor just for that intro. I'm gonna swap back to my badass Fallen Knight gear. There we go, I'm gonna get our Kylo Ren hood. And, the shield? Hold on. Let's equip a shield. Probably gonna need it. And we probably want a torch. Alright, look good. Cool. So before we continue on into Farron Keep, I believe it's called, let's talk to this dude who's now back. What have you pillaged for us, friend?
Oh, hello. You've come at a good time. Oh, it took some prowling, but I finally made a score.
Sick.
Go on, have a gander.
Oh, we don't get it for free. That's a bummer. So what did he get? Maybe lightning urn, bandit's knife, S stock, pontiff knight curved sword. Dude, he got the Zweihander. Well, anyone looking to get the Zweihander, fucking here it is. I can't quite get it yet, and you know, even if I could, I can't use it. Pontiff knight shield. Knight shield. So this must be the starting knight shield. What else? Just the straight up knight armor. And the assassin armor. Cool. Well, sweet, now he sells more stuff. What does the skill say on the Zweihander? Stomp. Yeah, that seems like what it was in the stress test. Okay, cool. Well, I know how to get the Zweihander now. That's pretty sweet. Let's talk to him some more.
You can keep the ring.
Yeah, got the ring.
Goodbye,
cool.
Mom.
Wait, what did he say?
Oh, hello. And
just to make sure.
Goodbye. And stay safe. Oh, this place is a bore.
Oh.
What good is thievery if you've nowhere?
Yeah, indeed. So I don't think there are any other NPCs to talk to right now. Don't fault me if I missed one. I mean, there was that assassin dude up top. Oh, you know what? I was thinking. I was trying to remember all the names of the lords. So there's Farron's Undead Legion, Saint Aldric of the Deep. Oh, the one I'm forgetting is this one right here. Yeah, Holy King Lothric. Okay, that's the one I'm missing.
Well, I'm Leon.
Oh.
Ringfinger.
What's up, Ringfinger?
Remember me? I slipped you those red eyes some time ago. You're making quite an effort of it, so I thought you might like to know. If you yearn for a proper red eye orb, one that is uncracked, then kill the dark wraith, survivor of the land swallowed by darkness. He has been a prisoner for many ages in the deepest cell in all Lothric.
Lift chamber key.
I can see it in your eyes. If you didn't invade, didn't pillage, whatever would you do?
Okay, guys. We're not going to go to the Farron Keep yet. We have a mission.
You fancy a proper red, then kill me as I can see.
The deepest, darkest cell. You know, that really reminds me of... Going to get nerdy here. I mean, fuck, we're playing Dark Souls. I mean, it's already pretty nerdy. But, I mean, not specifically Dark Souls, but playing a... fantasy action RPG. Anyway, it totally reminds me of the Witch King of Angmar, locked in the deepest, darkest recesses. Alright, well, we're gonna check it out. I assume that key... Well, hold on. Let's double check. I assume it's a key to the lift in the High Wall of Lothric. Let me see. Grave key, lift chamber key, lift... Key to the underground lift. Key to the room of the lift that descends to the deepest dungeon in Lothric. Yeah, okay. A surviving dark wraith from the land swallowed by darkness is said to be held there. From the land swallowed by darkness. I wonder if that is... Fuck. I forgot what it's called. I'll think of it maybe during the cutscene. Let's go. So we're going to travel to... Not the cathedral of the deep, but all the way back to the tower on the wall. Let's do it. Alright, and we're back, and I'm going to do a weird cut right here, because I want to look something up. It's nagging me. Alright, oh well. Anyway, let's head back down. I was trying to look up the name of the place that I couldn't think of, and it was proving to be far more difficult than it should have been. Oh, one shot these guys now. Nice. I checked, we need 4 Twinkling Titanite to upgrade this bad boy. So it's gonna be a little while. Hello, friend. Is this the... Yeah. I was gonna immediately try to parry this guy, because I find these guys are pretty easy to parry. But I can't parry them any, even if I wanted to. Cool, so I think this is where the key goes. Nice. In the stress test, you got a key that opened this, and I remember there being an elevator here. And once you went down here, you fought kind of the dude that we got this sword from, basically. So apparently there's a dark wraith down here now. Here are all these more decapitated red knights. Oh, fuck. That is a dark wraith. He's just standing there. Hey, friend, can I talk to you? Probably not, huh? Nope. Whoa. Yep, he's got his hand. I wonder what happens if he, I hit him with the backstab? Well then. Pretty sure I got him with the backstab, but even did the backstab animation. Oh, there's a dark hand. There we go. Well, at least it's cool to see the animation. We get the red eye orb. And the dark sword. Nice. Let's see what the dark sword does. Well, we can use it. 16 and 15. Pitch black straight sword of the dark wraith, survivor of the land swallowed by darkness. The dark wraiths were the first red eye orb invaders and originators of a unique sword technique inspired by their thick, broad blades. Skill stomp. That's a pretty big sword. Yep, that's the same one as the Zweihänder. You can follow it up with an attack. Can we follow it up with another? Seems to be only able to follow it up with the heavy attack. Oh, did a weird sweepy-doo. Huh. Interesting. It's kind of a cool sword. Doesn't have a scabbard, though. I don't know if I can use a sword that doesn't have a scabbard. I wonder if that's the only thing around here. It's interesting that they put the dark wraith down here for some reason. Maybe there's no abyss in the game? It doesn't look like there's anything else around here. Oh, we should probably read the red orb. I guess we can evade as much as we want now, which is sweet. Where is it? Here we go. Online play item. Invade other worlds at will. Blah, blah, blah. The red orb is rooted in a tiny land swallowed by darkness long ago. Some choose to put the orb to other uses. To embark on this path, enter the service of Rosaria in the Cathedral of the Deep. Well, we found the Cathedral of the Deep. We gotta go talk to Rosaria. It's kind of a cool sword. I dig it. What are the stats on it? 115. Has no special modifiers. Weight seems to be on par. Yeah, I mean, it's probably not too bad. I like the moveset, it's kind of cool. Yeah, I might use it at some point. But for now, I'm going to stick to our current setup, and we are going to go climb this ladder. and head back to Farron Keep, I think is where we want to go. I think that's better than going to the Cathedral of the Deep. Because of the knight dude we talked to, who was a total, was like a lady in my other one. He was like, or in my, if you didn't know, I'm playing through the game with two separate characters. This one's completely blind. And then in my spare time, you know, if I get 20 minutes here or there, I have a male character that I'm playing through with. And when I'm playing through with him, that knight who was a dude in this playthrough, there was like a knight and like his follower, and you talk to him and you get like the Blue Sentinel's covenant. Anyway, in my other playthrough when I was a male, he was a female. So that's really weird and interesting. Let's continue talking, but first travel to Farron Keep. Basically, my point was, is they said that the Cathedral of the Deep was past Farron Keep, which makes me think that Farron Keep is, like, what we should do first. So, yep, that's my reasoning. Let's do it. Farron Keep. All right, sweet. This place looks sweet. You can totally see it from up above on the high wall of Lothric, which I still think is like, ooh, I hear something. There's items all around. I don't trust any of this. Right, let's just head this way. Oh, I'm getting poisoned. Well then. Purple moss clump. Probably useful. We have some. Okay, let's equip some. Shall we? Cures poison, right? Oh, reduces poison buildup and cures poison. I don't think we have any poison resist stuff. Right? Yeah, okay. Well, fuck it, yo. Crap, it's getting chunky. I'll go ahead and use one. Ooh, iron flesh. That is a pyromancy. Ugh, fucking swampy area. I see an enemy moving around over there. Looks like a dog or something. Oh god, oh basilisks! No, no, no. Oh my god, I almost got cursed. I'm scared. Fuck out of here. There we go. Woo! Guess I'll just thump around. Oh, fuck that guy. Well, I can tell you right now, I do not like this area. Do not like it at all. You little bastard. Jump tech. Come on. There we go. Moss fruit. I don't know what that does, but that is fine. So basically my strategy is I'm going to hug this wall and head around before I jump into like the middle of it. If that makes any sense. Well, it looks like they don't really have any attacks other than trying to curse you. I don't really know what being cursed does in this game. In Dark Souls 1, it was terrible. You would instantly die and lose half of your health permanently until you found a way to break the curse. It was awful. And in Dark Souls 2, it's not that big of a deal. So, maybe it's somewhere in between. Secret wall? Nope. Yeah, need to get past these rocks. Oh, this place is so annoying. Fuck, I can just see the item over there, too. Let me get past it, yo. Damn it, I guess I have to go around here. Making me go around the thing. Is there like a trap or something? Is this gonna attack me? Okay. Suspicious of everything. I think that leads back up. Perhaps it leads back around to where that fucking dark yellow finger dickhead. Well, I guess he wants revenge. Oh. I think I saw him over there. Oh, yeah. Alright, friend. Fight him on the not slow ground. And a basilisk, of course. And two basilisks, of course. Let's get out of here. Behind this tree. Behind these guys. Definitely want to take care of the basilisks first. They have less health and are possibly more dangerous. As long as it doesn't, like, fucking magic sword me through the pillar, we should be fine. Alright, now we can focus on him. Shit. Oh, bullshit. Alright, well, huffing it back here. Alright, back fair and keep. Let's do it. Get past these fucking... I wonder if there's a ring I can get that makes it easier to walk on this goddamn awful area. And you know what? Should probably crack one of these, huh? Well, since there are a bunch of basilisks that way, if there's any items that I missed, just heading straight to the middle of this. I don't see any. I'm still wary of these like crucifix things. Well, it looks like if I hit, nope, he's coming for me anyway. God, these fucking basilisks. Part of me almost wants to just stand there and get hit by it to see what it does to me. It really threw me off. Like, just fighting the other dude and the basilisks. Ooh, definitely fuck out of that. Oh, I don't have my catalyst equipped. I should probably re-equip my catalyst. I can't even run. All you can do is dodge to move faster. Which is, you know, fine, I guess. God damn it, I just got cursed. Alright, so we're cursed, dead, health looks fine. Okay, so it insta-kills you, but it doesn't take away half your health. Okay. Well, that's good to know. I totally didn't mean to do that. I was just being... I don't know, I was being stupid. But... yeah, it's fine. It's fine, it's just wasting a little bit of time is all. Oh, yeah, fuck, I should equip my fucking catalyst like I said. Yep, I hear you fuckers. And I think to myself, why aren't I two-handing this? Because I'm not blocking any of their attacks. All they do is, like, poop out mist. Got him. These guys are pretty annoying for melee. Trying to save a little bit. Come on, dude. Give it a rest, man. Fuck it. I could have just killed him right there, but, you know. So annoying. Alright, where are the other ones? I plowed through most of them earlier. Eh, it still takes 3 hits. Come on. Get him. I really hate this area. The combination of the slow... like, the slow walking and the fucking basilisk. God damn it. I almost didn't realize I was getting getting cursed for a second. Alright, so, up here, we have that fucker who's gonna invade us. Pretty easy guy, all in all. Just have to be smart and not stand there and get hit a bunch of times. I wonder if I can retreat up there. He hasn't invaded me yet. Where are the basilisks that were behind him? Ooh. There's a path up here, too. Oh, there we go. Alright, well, let's force him up here. I wonder what's up here. Yeah, I don't want to aggro whatever the fuck that thing is. Oh, he's like invisible. Get back and heal up. Oh, his pick goes through my weapon, or goes through my shield. No wonder I died so quick. Well, fuck. God damn, it hurts. I was gonna say, on the bright side, he has no shield. On the downside, he kinda hurts now. Oh shit, he just healed himself. I should really equip like a better magic defense shield. Ah, damn it, I thought we could backstab on him. Alright, serpentine to avoid those. He's gotta run out of spells eventually. Dodge his attack. Fuck, immediately get punished. Come on. God, he hits so hard. I mean, I just gotta stun lock him. Oh, and then he heals. I hate this guy too. I mean, that's what you get for having him like be so easy the first time. And then now he's just, like, super brutal. Jesus fucking Christ. Okay, so we have no healing. There's a bunch of items up that lead back up that way. So I'm gonna go back to the bonfire. And I will cut back to here. Because I don't want... yeah. I don't want to bore you with running back and then running back again. So... we'll cut back right here in a second. Okay, and we're back. I just ran past all the basilisks, because fuck them. So, a couple things. I want to see what's behind there. I remember there's a couple basilisks back over here, too. Oh, here they come. At least one of them is. There's a little jump attack. Oh, we'll kill him. Let's get the other one over here. Can join in the fun. Nice. Well, they're not too bad if you can actually move. So I want to get up there. How do I get up there? Can I climb this? I cannot. I am poisoned again. Wonderful. We can also go up that way. I don't think I want to yet. Oh, there's another one. Oh, we can move properly. Get out of it, get out of it. Get out of the fuck zone. Oh, and another one. They were not shy about putting, like, just a billion basilisks. Just gonna shoot them. Because they're annoying. One's dead. Oh, get out of it. Let's head back here. We can actually move properly. He's just gonna be a little bitch. There we go. Repair powder. Here is another basilisk. No mercy. No mercy for basilisks. This area looks explodey. Okay, well, I no longer have my torch equipped, so let's slap our torch back on. What do you have? Golden scroll. Okay, so this thing has been opened and pillaged, and this one hasn't. Okay, it's not a mimic. Okay, sweet. Trapped? No, okay, sweet. Ooh, antiquated dress? This is Dusk's gear from Dark Souls 1. Dress sewn in a long-lost fashion, the elaborately embroidered ivory-colored silk is imbued with ancient magic power. No protection is offered by this garment, as it was never intended for battle, but it does have high resistances, including poison and curse. Well, I guess we'll equip it, just to see. Yeah. Look how pretty we are. And we also got the scroll? By the way, we're sticking with our armor. It doesn't have very good resistances for where we are, but it looks awesome. So, it's all that matters. Fallen Knights and the Fallen Knight helmet. Kylo Ren helm. And finally, let's go look at the scroll. Probably key items, huh? Learn sorceries from Ulysseal. Okay, so this is what that dude wants from us. A golden scroll chronicling the vast research of the Xanthus sorcerer, or Xanthus scholars. Give to a sorcerer to learn the arts of Ulysseal. In the lost lands of Ulysseal, the sorceries orchestrated light and were said to shine in golden hues. Okay. Cool, so we can give that dude stuff, so he can teach us stuff. Secret? Nope. Don't want to be poisoned. I definitely want to somehow get back up there. That's definitely going to be something. See that bulbous thing hanging down? I'm a little scared. Wary, even. Let's just keep going around this way. I feel there's gotta be like a secret or something around here. Wait a minute, what was that? Oh, there's just fires in the distance. And there's a opening right here. I definitely don't trust these hanging things. Ooh, what is this? What the fuck is this? I should probably heal. I was getting a little ahead of myself. Light it. Is this where... Is this the door that opens up after we put out all the fires or something? They didn't mention something like that. To open up the wolf's gate or some effect. Oh, there's a slug. There's a lot of slugs. Alright, well, it's not a... Let's get hit by the slugs. The slugs kind of remind me of the slime things on your way to Blighttown in the sewer type area in Dark Souls 1. I don't remember what it's called. Should really play Dark Souls 1 again. I think we got them all. Undead Bone Shard. Awesome. That, like, will boost the power of our Estus Flask. Okay, so... man, I keep thinking I'm gonna get to, like, a good... Ooh, heavy gem. A good stopping point, but there isn't really here. I still want to get up top. Oh, there's a huge thing walking around there. I wonder if there's another bonfire near. I wonder what's in... Nothing, okay. Well, let's get this item. Titanite shard, nice. So this is basically Blighttown 2.0, and it sucks just as much. Yeah, these blobs gotta do something. Maybe not. They look like they do, though. Oh, dude, bonfire. Okay, sweet. So I think this is a good place to stop. What the hell is this thing? Hold on, I'm gonna sneak up on it. Be very, very quiet. We're hunting clickers. They look like clickers from... Oh, God. They look like clickers from Last of Us. Like some sort of poison knights. So the poison is probably not super effective because there's already just poison everywhere anyway. Like, do miracles? Oh, there's the other one. Snuck back around. Yeah, they're not too bad. Alright, so I think it's a good time to stop the episode. If you like the episode, then maybe leave a like, maybe even subscribe, that'd be awesome. Regardless of what you do, thank you very much for watching, and I hope to see you next time. Have a good one, all. Bye-bye.